I think, Dr. Mishra, very frankly, we had not cheated on the slide deck before this. So I have to share this with you. The three or four issues that he has brought about are the issues that I'm going to talk about today. The last issue is very important and very close to my heart. It's how does India democratize its own platforms such that technology is accessible to everybody in India at scale, at a cost that India can afford. And I think that's a very important discussion, sir, and I will throw my views to it and what we are trying to do. So I start off my discussion with a simple point that I have been talking about for the last 2 years, and that is data is the new oil. And I want to take you to really, when you go back today, to keep that one statement in your mind, because it is the new oil. The new generation is producing data like we have never produced before. Last year, the amount of video content that got produced till 2016, we have already surpassed the actual cumulated amount of video that got produced till 2016. We have surpassed that in 2017 already. And the same will repeat next year. That's the amount of data consumption that is happening. And you talk about digital divide. In a country like India, how many of you in this room don't have a WhatsApp? The answer is zero. There is one person there, probably on another messenger, Outliner. Two, how many of you in this room don't have an Aadhaar number? About three or four. Today, you're talking about building a digital infrastructure. India is at the forefront of building the world's leading digital infrastructure. And it's pretty amazing how and in what speed we have built this infrastructure in India. Right here, made in India, for Indians. The digital infrastructure is such that it can be used by anybody on either side of the digital divide. That's the basic design principle of the infrastructure India has built. And it ties into this whole theory of data as the new oil. Because so far, India has been the biggest producer of data that India has not monetized. None of us have monetized. If you see the top five companies in the world today, top four or five companies in the world today, they're no longer the Exxon Mobils or the Citibanks of the world or the GEs of the world. They're all data and digital companies. The Facebooks, the Googles, the Amazons, the Apples, those are the companies. And when we use our data, oh, there it works. When we use our data, everybody else makes money off it. But India does not. And India has the biggest digital footprint in the world today. Keep that in mind. We have the biggest footprint. And these are some of the numbers. They keep changing very, very fast. We have 1.1 billion people on a mobile connection. We have 1.12 billion people, higher than that. Every single adult on an Aadhaar system today, digital identity. Forget anything else about Aadhaar, but remember, it's the biggest digital identity system in the world. All of you should know one thing. You can sign a document digitally today with or without a smartphone using your Aadhaar. Any document, by the way. And still, people are making us sign 10, 20 pages of documents, physical papers. All that is gone. And that's the disruption that India is promoting. India has already developed the base technology for that. 500 million bank accounts. In a matter of less than 1 year, India added 220 million bank accounts. Less than 1 year. Jandhan accounts. And that's remarkable. No country in the world. That's three times the working population of United Kingdom, by the way. We added in 1 year. Now, what this has done, this Aadhaar mobile bank accounts, this trinity is called the Jam Trinity, and that's the basic infrastructure, Dr. Mishra, that no country has replicated in the world. Because of that, today, we have a massive disruption going on. And guess what? What is the second big thing in this? This works with the digital, with the internet connection, without internet connection. And that's something that is very, very important. It's a message of inclusion. Lastly, we have 450 million internet users in India, thanks to a particular service that got offered last year. Which do you know how many million connections that particular service added in less than 170 days? 100 million. 170 days, 92% first-time users. But do you know what the beauty of that was? And I will come to that. The beauty of that was this. This is something called India Stack. All of you have access to this. All of us have access to this. It is the basic identity layer interconnected with payment systems that India has built. Now, coming to Dr. Mishra's point about costs. Far too long, India and many countries in the world have depended upon global intellectual property being used in India. And they have their own cost structures. We have a payment system in India that virtually works at 1/10 the cost of any payment structure in the world. That's why we can enable low-cost banking. That's how we have brought down the cost of banking transactions from 2 percentage points to 20 basis points. That's 1/10. Two, this is tied into something called Dropbox on steroids. Any of you use Dropbox here? Or Dropbox, whatever else? We have DigiLocker. It's free of service. It's a free cost service. Anybody can use it. And how do you access this? It's through JAM. You can access this through your Aadhaar account, through your mobile, through your bank account. That is the universality we have built into our system. All these things are integrated with each other. This is a government which has broken all silos, building this infrastructure called JAM, based on a thing called India Stack, which is a innovation as a public good. No country in the world has this infrastructure, number one. Number two, the scale of this infrastructure is worth billions and billions of dollars in IP and intellectual property. And this is something that is a public good that India has made. That's a very important point. This is innovation as a public good. This is available to any company, any organization, and the first user of this was the government. And I'll give you a lot of examples for that. But the user that I want to relate to you was this telecom company last year. What did it do? It made the onboarding process, the customer acquisition process, completely paperless. You walked into a Jio phone, gave your Aadhaar number, verified yourself, and done. Your eKYC, electronic KYC, was done. Now forget what offers they had, and I'm not going to comment on that. That's their business model. What's important is, what's very, very important is, they onboarded a customer at a dollar cost versus $30, $25 to $30 that takes a regular business to onboard a customer. In a completely paperless, at scale, and at, in a compressed time that nobody could imagine. That company was adding 7 users per second. No adoption has been faster than that. And the important thing in that is, while we can give allocates to that company for adding that many users, the base system was a government technology. Who built this? Who owns this? Not one of these FAGA companies, Facebook, Apple, Google, Amazon. But Indian, all of us own this technology. And that's the key message. We own this. We own this platform today. India has created, and we should applaud this, the biggest platform in the world that everybody is watching today. Everybody is watching this platform. Politics apart, this is the platform that will disrupt, has already disrupted banking. So I'm going to come, there's one other interesting thing that people mentioned. This room, probably everybody has a smartphone. But a very important thing that has been happening in India is build out of this India Stack, the JAM Trinity, from a government perspective. Secondly, the rise of the smartphone. If you all read what is called the Mary Meeker report on internet trends, one of the biggest thing that report follows is the rise of the smartphones, the net smartphones in a country, because that's aspirational. That's, you know, bridging the digital divide, and also showing the kind of smartphones people buy shows the aspiration levels. The great thing in India, the highest net additions of smartphone in the world are happening in India. 120 million per year, about 27, 28 million per quarter. This is net new additions. Great trend. Please watch out for this trend. And keep them. A lot of people measure a lot of other things, and I'm sure as consumer marketers, you know, you watch out for a lot of trends. This is an exciting trend from a digital journey, because this trend defines, you know, how fast digital revolution is happening in a particular society. Innovation as a public good, I already talked about that. India Stack. Technology for 1.2 billion Indians. Everybody today has access to it. And the second lesson, it's the scale of this is so massive that no other system and platform can compete with it. It's transactions. And a lot of people don't understand the volume of transactions we are doing on this. Last month, in July, or month before last, we did 94 crore authentications on the system. That means on an average of about 3.5 crore per day. That many people are actually using on a daily basis the volumes. When we think of volumes, and again, an old example, the digital journey of India. If you think of bookings online, you'd think of Travelocity, booking.com. But there is another small website in India. Can anybody guess what that is? IRCTC does actually more number of travel bookings per day than all the global travel websites combined together. So the problem of scale, the problem of low cost, India has always embraced. Today, the time has come that we are actually using it to solve it. And the only thing that I want to highlight here, the government has been the biggest adopter of technology. The government couldn't have leapfrogged the way we have leapfrogged. We couldn't have achieved the timelines of demonetization of now GST. GST is also linked to this India Stack, by the way. All your GST transactions are linked to the India Stack. And that's how we have been breaking the silos of information that existed in the government. GST, for those of you who don't comprehend, is the biggest cloud system in the world today. Again, everything in India has to be the biggest, guy. 2.5 billion invoices are going to be uploaded in the cloud every month. 2.5 billion. And they're going to be also not only uploaded, but also being, you know, the tax input credit, the output, all going to be matched in the cloud. That's the scale of it. But what does the scale achieve? What does that it do?
Arvind, you are into the last 2 minutes.
Absolutely, I'll finish in 2 minutes. And I will talk about that, what does it do. Let me quickly do one more thing. I want to, you know, Dr. Mishra talked about the old. Aadhaar solves the old problem, sir. 90 lakh people today don't leave their homes to get their pensions. Earlier, they had to walk in the Munna Bhai MBBS style to a government office and prove that they are alive every year. 90 lakh people sit from their home, certify they are alive, get their pensions directly into their bank account using an Aadhaar system. That's technology for the poor people. That's technology for the real people. The numbers are amazing. I'm not going to talk about numbers. I'm going to leave you with two other thoughts. One is, you talked about how this is relevant to HR leadership. Social, all of you know about. Cloud is really disrupting everything. Today, from a CapEx model, everything has moved to OpEx, outcome-based approach. And from a, today, I think if you talk about the top leaders in the world on social, only India figures in the one and two list. Right? And you know what I'm talking about. Same thing for cloud. The biggest new cloud installations are happening in India. Cloud is the new way, and that's the advantage of leapfrogging. Third thing is AI. And that's all driven by what? What is AI driven on? AI is driven on data. Without data, AI doesn't work. Okay? And that's the next trend that all of you should be watching out for. The messenger has become the new browser. 3.8 billion people, various users across the world use a different messenger. 1.2 billion people on Facebook Messenger alone. I think something that you need to be watching out for very, very aggressively. As I said, limited on time, data is the new oil. The amount of data India is producing, the opportunities it brings to any leadership, HR, any community is absolutely mind-blowing. And from a very, very data-poor nation, we are suddenly leapfrogged to a very, very data-rich nation. In 2 years, from being 155th in the amount of data user per person, you know, guess what's the rank last year, or actually 3 months ago? Number one, thank you. So data is the new oil. The government is embracing it. Banks are embracing it. You talked about, you know, I think India is leapfrogging in banking. It's a global role model in the world, what India has done to payments and in banking. And I think we have a great platform, the India Stack, the Jam Trinity. Everybody can leverage it. Every business, every entrepreneur, every startup can leverage it. Please go and do it. Thank you.